Welcome to Kensho Quest. In this video, I'm going to show you what's in our minimalist travel first aid kit and also our natural homeopathic remedies kit.
One, two, three,
aloha!
We are Kensho Quest.
We travel to open our minds and our hearts.
Let's express around the world!
First, let's take a close look inside the travel first aid kit. This bag is just something I picked up at Target while I was buying some of the contents for a first aid kit. Here's what's inside. Right on top, we have some acetaminophen. That's just headache medicine for my husband. He does tend to get headaches if we don't get enough sleep before a flight. We have our trusty ACE bandage that's been all around the world with us. Some tape for taping on gauze pads. I realized that I like to have one that comes with a dispenser, so that way, even if I don't have any little scissors in my first aid kit, I can cut the tape. To go along with that, we have some gauze pads in case anybody gets a scraped knee. In place of Neosporin, this time we're going to be taking this Calendula cream. So it's for cuts, scrapes, or burns. You can rub some of this on there. This is 2.5 ounces, so it would work to put this in a clear bag and bring it on the plane in a carry-on bag. I have one of these Welly tins. I like to get their kits and then kind of change it up a little bit, customize it. So I've added in here some Arnica Montana pain reliever for our kids. Also some rescue remedy drops. We like them to take these before an airplane flight or a big travel day. We have some of the Welly bandages down here at the bottom. And then it came with these little tiny packets. This is triple antibiotic ointment, so similar to Neosporin, some hydrocortisone cream, and also some little hand sanitizers as well. So this is something we always have on us. I've been carrying this in the diaper bag recently. We have our good old trusty fisherman's friends. Always like to have those with us on a travel day. Cold Calm is a homeopathic remedy, so if any of us feels like we're starting to come down with a cold, then we can start to take this. We have our activated charcoal. If anybody gets some food poisoning, a bad stomach ache, they can take this. I have a little medicine bag in here just to keep some small items organized. Some additional homeopathic remedies that don't fit in our main travel kit. Antiseptic towelettes, so this is to wipe a little cut, clean it up before bandaging it. Some little alcohol prep pads to clean around the wound. And the final item we have in here is some Ultima Replenisher electrolyte mix that you can just add with water. We took this on our last travels. It was really great for long days out. When we're in really hot weather, I usually pack the kids' water bottles with just water, but then I'll pack up one water bottle for us to share with an electrolyte. It's a good little recharge if we get super thirsty. So you can see I like to keep this pretty basic and simple, just the necessities we might need right away. Any other medicine, if it turns out we need while we're traveling, we can get it at a pharmacy or a hospital along the way. Now let's look inside the Homeo travel kit. This is the one that came pre-filled, so if you're shopping for this kit, make sure that you're getting the one that comes pre-filled with 16 remedies and not just the case alone. And I found that the brand I like, Boiron, I'm sure I'm mispronouncing it, but you can see it right here. They actually offer this Homeo travel kit, and this is the filled version, so it comes along with 16 remedies inside, and therefore ailments that you're likely to have while traveling. The kit comes with remedies for a high fever, mild or low fever, allergies, swelling from insect bites or allergies, food poisoning, diarrhea with gas and bloating, motion sickness, abdominal cramps improved by bending over, sleeplessness with mental hyperactivity, stage fright, muscle pain and stiffness, swelling from injuries or discoloration from bruising, nerve pain, spasmodic pain in the abdomen improved by heat, heartburn or drowsiness due to excessive eating or drinking, and also diarrhea with intestinal growling. And this kit is really cool. It opens on two different sides. I like how it keeps it nice and easy to see the remedies. and then it kind of pops open here and it holds them in place really well so they're not moving around. I wasn't sure at first if this case is worth the price because it's kind of pricey even if you were to buy it on its own, not filled. But now I see it is really cool to keep these tubes nicely organized. And I like that you can read right through it so it would be easy to find the remedy you're looking for. I'm noticing one is missing here. My husband's been using that because he got some food poisoning recently. If you're not at all familiar with homeopathics, the way they work is they're extremely diluted version of a natural substance, and they're in these little round balls that are like little sugar pellets, and you take 5 of them at a time. The tube dispenses them really carefully, so you get exactly however many you need, and the instructions tell you how frequently to take them. You just dissolve them under your tongue. It's really easy to do. There's no big pills or something that you have to swallow. I want to say here, I am not an expert in homeopathy. I've just been getting more into it over the years, and none of this is medical advice. I am not a medical doctor. This is just sharing our family's personal preferences and personal experiences. So always do your research, and you can consult your own expert when deciding exactly what you want to take for your travel medicine. Together, these weigh 2 pounds. I know every family is unique, but I hope that gave you some ideas of what you might want to pack in your travel first aid kit and your travel remedies kit. Please subscribe for more packing tips and travel inspiration.